Of certain excerpts from the works of Alleluia. First, we have some parts of Masses which he has written. There are many Masses in both English, Hindi, Portuguese. We are presenting to you parts of the Masses. Misanto, Misanto Toriba, Majoriora, Diora, Magil, Amitunchuka, Ode, Antoni, Kachin, Bokhtigida, Iesu prokas, voikuttant. Vesper, which is Sajiji Pratana, Yamcha Bhuvisovina Nikunta,
Festa Nazareth Argenza, mi vesco che con il barone da 12 amananti nel vesco dolente di aver restante il stop in cibo carattere oltre Psalm 145 e non c'è il 13 e 9 ma che quando di là torniamoci pare di pronto in carina tanto per il svegliere a te in carina magari si riesce a trovare
thank you. Jesu Christ, Sotmantam. Thank you. Pinto gives mission at Galgibaga through the help of Father João Batista, Professor Saligao Sacret, and so many others once they come in his life. He developed and he allowed God to intelligence in him to shine. And he did not just achieve the title of a doctor in music, but he showed it in his life that he had really mastered the art of music. He himself used to play violin, he played piano, he played the harmonium, he played flute when required, he played cello, so he played a number of instruments, and he learned by sheer hard work. But the Vietnam prophet once said to us in our refectory that he had taken one of his compositions for execution in Bombay. They were preparing a set, musical set, and the arrangement was by Father Lourdino Barreto. And you know, in Bombay there are musicians who are very good at playing film music and all types of high standard performances while executing this particular piece that was arranged by Father Lourdino Barreto. The violinists who were performing that particular piece asked Father Bernard Gordon, "Who is this person who has composed this music?" And he said, "It's Father Lourdino Barreto, one of our priests from Goa." And he said, "Are there such people in Goa? People who can compose this kind of music?" So, my dear friends, he had reached a stage of such great perfection that yet he was a simple person. Saro, Ajam, Ji, Zirinur, Mache, Borok, strict, he was strict, but he had a loving heart. And he wanted to get the best out of what was available. And so, he would pick out from the seminarians those who were able to perform something. And one of them is myself. We have a number of us here. Father Savio is here, who's also performing. Father Jesus is here. We are sitting here, but there were times when we were pulled up and we were part of the Philharmonic Choir and the Goa Symphony Orchestra, when Adruti would encourage us to go along with him. I remember at one point of time he gathered people from all over Goa, choirs which were from Mandan side, from Tantin side, from Bartan side, one of them was ours. It was of the seminary. Little ones, we were, at that time I was just in the 10th century. So he picked up the best opportunities so that people could groom themselves, people could grow in the talent of music. I say I myself because I want to relate this to you so that you can understand what Fatimuddin was. When I joined the seminary, I played the double bass. That was the first instrument he gave me, because there was nobody who played the double bass at that time in the seminary. So he was looking at the need of the seminary. The needed person who played the double bass, so he played the double bass. But then there was somebody else who showed interest in double bass, and there was need for some blowing instruments. And he asked, would you like to learn some blowing instruments? I said, yes, I'd like to learn trumpet. And so he shifted me from double bass. I did quite well in double bass, but that was not all. He wanted something more. So he shifted me to trumpet. And I joined him. The seminary starts in the month of June. So June, July, August, 3 months. In the month of August, 15th of August, we have the feast of Assumption, or the Lord Lord, when you are being counted for the feast. And so you can understand, for the first 2 months, I was playing the double bass, and maybe 1.5 months, a little more, maybe. So within 1 month, I was able to play only 3 notes of trumpet. Lord, word, law, so, do. You understand? You understand me? This was the only 3 notes that I played. Do, so, do. And if you know trumpet, they are all open notes. You know, there are 3 buttons in trumpet, and they are all open notes. Do, so, do. Those were the first notes that I had to learn. I never thought that a routine would push me into the orchestra. But he did. I said, in 3 notes, how could I play? He wrote the paper for me. With the 3 notes that I knew, I had to be there part of the orchestra. And those 3 notes I played, hopefully I played them. So, the thing is, I want to tell you that Father Murthy did not spare anyone. And he wanted to get the best out of it. The little that we had. And I know that he used to write music according to the ability of the people who are participating in the orchestra. And that's what he did. When people knew to just play a little bit of violin, they would be there, you know, as part of the orchestra. The little music that the child, the student would be able to, he would write that music and accordingly put them. And it was such a joy for me to be part of the orchestra on a feast day. I felt great. Oh. And so he encouraged us. And that is what we wanted. He wanted to know the best. And that is his business. My dear friends, I'm not going to give you a long speech, but just a few words which speak about how Father Lourdino in his life helped people in various ways. This is in music. He used to silently, I know, he used to silently help people who are in need. He had a talent for mechanics. He himself used to clean up his car, go under the car, and call us also to learn what he was doing. I remember at one point of time, there was some celebration in his parish, Galgibaga. And he took it priest in his parish also, and he wanted to put up a play. But they did not have the type of backdrop that he needed. So he himself, at the seminary, tried to paint that backdrop and took the help of the seminarians to draw that whole curtain backdrop, which is a big thing, spread out throughout the whole room, one of the rooms we were speaking, and we did that. You see how he struggled. He worked hard to bring out the best again, to reach out. And that's what Mother Lourdes was for us. A man of principles. A person who would stand for the truth. You know, at the end, what his struggle was. He stood for the truth, fought for the truth, and finally was reinstated back at the Gala event. So, I'm really happy today that Father Romeo, on the occasion of his 25 years of his passing away, has put up this beautiful program. I was saying that as seminarians, we have the privilege of being part of the Goa Philharmonic Choir and also part of the Goa Symphony Orchestra. As I was listening to the performance today, I thought to myself, Father Lourdino, with all our imperfections and with all our limitations, probably was not satisfied with the performance that we had done at that time, during the time of Lourdino, because being part of it, I knew what was happening. So when I was listening to your beautiful performance, I said, you have done a great job in perfecting the execution of what Luigi wrote down. Maybe because I was sitting right up here, I enjoyed the balance of the music and the choir. And it came out really, really beautiful. Congratulations, Father. For creating these music lovers, young, energetic, to come up with such a perfection. I'm really happy the way the whole program is arranged. It began with the recital of the inaugural part. Began with that in Gregorian chant and the Latin Pater Noster, and followed with Ave Maria. That really set the tone to have a spiritual experience in today's performance. And one thing I will really say with all sincerity is the perfection in your synchronization. The way the choir synchronized your performance is really great. It was like just one voice. And the balance of the music as well as the singing was so, so perfect. I think they need a great clap. looks like, or reminds us of our beauty. Yes, very true. I agree with the way of because as Father Lourdino was conducting the choir, surely reminded me of Father Lourdino. Many of the gestures that Father Lourdino has incorporated in himself are part of Father Lourdino. And so it reminded me very much. And why does that happen? It happens because Father Lourdino himself was a student of Father Lourdino Barreto, even before he joined the seminary. And Father Lourdino was his, like a star. He was the model. Father Lourdino, I know personally, was a young seminarian. And we always spoke about Father Lourdino as a great example. And this performance is an expression of his belief. I thank you, Father Lourdino, for taking time. You know, I know you are a busy person, but to make time for this type of performance is a great sacrifice. And sacrifices are performed when there is love in the heart. And that's what he has. He has love in his heart for Father Lourdino. And that is the reason why I would say he has left no stone unturned to see that something beautiful happens. I know that all the participants, those who make music and those who sang, they are from different parts of Goa. And to have practices, it is not easy. You have to travel. You have to spend time. Sometimes, I don't know if Father Lourdino also has some parts of Father Lourdino where he gets upset. Because Father Lourdino also had a little bit of a short temper. That is part of artists. It happens with all of us who are artists. We are a little short tempered. So it is part of life. And it is not easy to go through all that. So congratulations to all of you who have been part of this exercise and part of this performance, which has really of a very high standard. Congratulations to all of you, and especially to Father Lourdino. Thank you.
Children of your parents, you can't do anything. सगळ्यांक म्हाका आसतलो की सगळे फ्री रावन सगळे एवरेज पर्यंत